وتبارك الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض وعنده علم الساعة وإليه ترجعون.
كن فريدا، عش بفخر في الحياة، لا تبالي.
Start off with one, and Yahya, just two of you just line up here. The rest of you just step up. Just Yahya here, and what's your name, bro? Oh, so we go in twos just behind there, yeah? So Yahya will lead. So we go this way. So, for example, the cones on the outside, you don't go inside the cones, yeah? You show on the outside, you just jump all the way around. If I blow the whistle once, it's a walk. If I blow the whistle twice, it's a jog. If I blow the whistle three times, it's a run. Okay, so if I blow the whistle once, what is it? If I blow the whistle twice, it's a... If I blow the whistle three times, it's a... All right, so the two of you, just start walking, just start walking. All right, next two, go on, just walk. Just walk, just walk. Next two, go.
He's a boy.
I'm from Somalia, bro. Somalia.
كن بهذا العصر من أعلامه ودع الأحلام يا فارسنا كن بهذا
آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين
آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين.
للحافظات اليوم عطر ياسمين كانت لهم بالخير. خير أحلام السنين. إنا نبارككم على أغلى الوعود يوم التخرج بالسعادة كلها.
وجعلنا الليل والنهار آيتين فمحونا آية الليل وجعلنا آية النهار مبصرة لتبتغوا فضلا من ربكم ولتعلموا عدد السنين والحساب وكل شيء فصلناه تفصيلا وكل إنسان ألزمناه طائره في عنقه ونخرج له يوم القيامة كتابا يلقاه منشورا اقرأ كتابك كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيبا من اهتدى فإنما يهتدي لنفسه ومن ضل فإنما يضل عليها ولا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى وما كنا معذبين حتى نبعث رسولا صدق الله العظيم.
المسلم يسجد whoever recites the Quran من قرأ القرآن وعمل بما فيه and has acted upon the Quran whatever that's in it and you remember the Quran, you perfected it and then you actually implement that in your life. The Messenger said أُلْبِسَ وَالِدَهُ حَاجًا يُمْهُ الْقِيَامِ. The parent of that child, of that memorizer of the Quran, their parents will be made to wear a crown on the day of judgment. This crown of honor. حَاجًا يُمْهُ الْقِيَامِ ضَوْءُهُ أَحْسَنُ مِنْ ضَوْءِ الشَّمْسِ. The light of that crown is going to be better, or it's going to be more brighter than the sun. And then he said, the messenger said, "فَمَا بَالُكُمْ." He said, "What is going to be the case of the person that عَمِلَ بِهَذَا?" So what about let alone the person who memorized the Quran? If the parents are going to be given that honor, then imagine the child. And also, there's another hadith that the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about the person who has memorized the Quran. Look at this. Imagine in front of the whole creation. Imagine where Ibrahim alayhi salam is present and all the human beings that ever lived before that are living, the human beings that are living on the earth now, 7 billion people that are living now. And those to come in the future, everyone, in front of everyone, you're going to be cool. And يُوضَعُ لَهُ تَاجٌ تَاجٌ وَقَارٌ. You'll be made to wear a crown of honor. Imagine, that's what memorized the Quran, you'll be made to wear تاج of honor. And also the hadith says, وَيُكْسَ وَالِدَاهُ حُلَّتَيْنِ. The parents, the child who has memorized the Quran, the parent of that child will be made to wear two beautiful garments from the garments of Jannah. It's an honor. حُلَّتَيْنِ. And then the message said, لَا يُقَوَّمُ أَهْلُ الدُّنْيَا. لَا يُقَوَّمُ لَهُمَا أَهْلُ الدُّنْيَا. That the people of the dunya will never be able to, even if they had so much money to buy these garments, they will never be able to do so. This is an honor given to the people of the Quran. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in many occasions about the status of his people. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about the person, I mean like Imam Shatibi rahmatullahi alayhi, when he spoke about the person of the Quran and the companionship of the Quran, he said, وَخَيْرُ جَلِيسٍ لَا يُمَلُّ حَدِيثًا. It's the best. It's the best one that you can sit with. لَا يُمَلُّ حَدِيثُهُ. Who you will never be bored of sitting with. Talking about the Quran, the Quran is the best companion to sit with, is that you never get bored of sitting with. تَغْدَادُهُ وَزْدَادُ فِي تَجَمِّلَهُ. And its recitation increases its beauty. The more you recite the Quran and you get close to the Quran, you are elevated, you are purified, you love to even recite the Quran even more.
This is the only book. There are millions and millions of books in the world. And every day a new book is offered. A new one is advertised. Someone somewhere in the world has something to say. And he's selling his story, he's selling his philosophy, he's telling whatever he wants to tell you, whatever he thinks or she thinks is guidance. you see in the big, you know, shops of the book industry, Waterstone, W.H. Smith, etc., whole sections of smart thinking, you know, going forward, you know, self-help books, all these things, they are there to tell you that we are the guidance. We are here to guide you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts with the first surah, first few ayats, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام ميم ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه. This is the book. This book, لا ريب فيه. There is no doubt in anything that it says. Not a word is false. There is no error of any kind. لا ريب فيه. Okay, that's number one fact stated. This is the best you can hope for in anything you read. Okay, that it's a fact. Allah tells you, guarantee. La rayba fi. Be in no doubt in the truthfulness of this book and what it has to say on any subject, on any conceivable subject. And it covered anything that you can ask for or think about. As Allah says in other parts of the Quran, tibyan li kulli shay'in wa hudan wa maw'idah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, pointing to this point, that the Quran is inclusive in speaking on any subject. Decisively, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا فَرَطْنَا فِي الْكِتَابِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. We left nothing, you know, unclarified. We clarified everything that you can think about as a human being. And this is the end of time. From the beginning of its revelation, from what's past, from the beginning of the creation, it started from the Qalam, that writes the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of the Lawh al-Mahfuz, until the last thing to happen in this world. Can you believe one book containing all this information and in a very decisive manner? This is only the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah says, who then? This book is guidance. On what? What is it guide about? What does it help you with? What does it tell you? On all that you can think about, anything, for the dunya and for the akhirah. It's there.
Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Ayyuha al-ikhwa wa al-akhawat, ayyuha al-hafl al-kareem, uhayyikum bi tahiyyati al-islam. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أسأل الله تبارك وتعالى أن يجعلنا من أهل القرآن الذين هم أهل الله وخاصة. مع الرباء هنا دور كلمة دور. I want to say a few words. The first one is to the students, the youngest who are in the masjid. First of all, remember, you're sitting in a gathering which is the best of the gatherings. The best meeting people have, and the best gathering they have is where we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the best halaqa someone can have in his life. So know you are in a masjid, you pray the salah, alhamdulillah, in masjid, and we're here to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the best gathering we have is the gathering of Quran. Even the malaika, they will remember you, they pray for you, because you are talib al-ilm. Everything in the seas will pray for you. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "من سلك طريقا يلتمس به علما سهل الله له به طريقا الى الجنه." وكما قال عليه الصلاه والسلام, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned the hadith, whoever goes the path of knowledge, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it easier for him and he takes him to path of jannah. This is طريق الى الجنه. And the great thing here is we are hafl khitam Quran, hafl takreem, we say in Arabic. We honor our friends and our students because of the khatm of the Quran. This is for us to remember and them to remember. and inshallah in the future they will have this one and bigger بإذن الله تبارك وتعالى. This is honored and given by not from madrasa, it's from the youth. It means from youth to youth, alhamdulillah. It's from the youth, youngst, and معلمين of the youth. Allah يحفظهم علي سعيد بلال محمد and all of those who give hand. Brother Adam and Abdullah and everyone here and the sisters as well. They are always like Sheikh Abdul Wali, the dad of Ahmed mentioned, the front line of the khair, and that's how they work in this ummah. So youth, the first thing I will remind you is, because if you come to the gathering of Quran, that should make us all love Quran. We have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this ni'mah, ni'mat al-Qur'an. Allah gave something special to every messenger, every prophet. Allah says in the Qur'an, وَلَقَدْ مَنَنَّا عَلَى مُوسَى وَهَارُونَ وَنَجَّيْنَاهُمَا وَقَوْمَهُمَا مِنَ الْكَرْبِ الْعَظِيمِ. Allah gave them miracles, favors, ni'am Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them. But when it comes to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what was the ni'mah Allah gave it to him? This is the greatest ni'mah. Allah says in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِّنَ الْمَثَانِي وَالْقُرْآنَ الْعَظِيمِ. Allah gave him the surah that comes back 7 times, Al-Mathani. It's been repeated and recited again and again, Surah Al-Fatiha. It's the greatest ni'mah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the Quran. Allah says what? وَالْقُرْآنَ الْعَظِيمِ. Who says Al-Qur'an Al-Azim? The great Qur'an. Allah Jalla Jalalah. Allah Rabbul Arsh Al-Azim is saying, we give you Surah Al-Fatiha. Mufassirin, they say, Sab'a Al-Mathani is Fatiha and Wal-Qur'an Al-Azim. This is the ni'mah. This mu'jiza, miracle that stays. This Qur'an is huda and is nur, is guidance. It's hidayah, it's the rahmah, it's the mercy, it's the shifa. We cure ourselves, this is our medicine we have. It's in the Quran, our shifa, our health is in the Quran. So, youngster, when it comes to the Quran, we're talking about the greatest thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wal Quran al hazim. The greatest Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ever given to human being is the Quran, and that given to you, the best of the Anbiya, Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam. Quran is mu'jiza, it's miracle. People, they don't even know up to now what Quran is talking about. Quran is talking about what you need now. Quran is talking about the past, the Anbiya, the Kutub. The revelation is all included in the Quran. It's all in this Kitab, the books, the Torah, the Injil, the Zabur, the Ibrahim. And all those that come to the messengers is all included in the Quran. Quran is there, not as a history. Allah is there to mention and to correct what the Ummah after the Anbiya they added to their religion. They added cross. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا صَلَبُوا. They didn't cross Isa. وَمَا قَتَلُوا. They said they killed him not. They changed the Torah, the Jew. Quran is corrected. يُحَرِّفُونَ الْكَلِمَ عَنْ مَوَاضِعِهِ. Allah mentioned that in the Quran. Quran is to correct the incorrect things they added to the deen.
يا حامل القرآن قد خصك الرحمن بالفضل والتيجان والروح والريح.
What did you think of the boy?
Quite mashallah. I respect the
prophets.
Alhamdulillah,
it's Quran.
I might be here
with you. Salam. Isn't it quite recent?
Who's that?
Then, what do you think about the boy?
Which one?
Vlogger. What do you think about the boy?
Mashallah.
Yahya, what do you think about the boy?
Alhamdulillah. It's very inspiring. Good to be with me. Inshallah. I'm doing my best to make my journey.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, as you can see today, we're shopping for the youth, mashallah. They're in for youth sleepover. So I hope we can see you guys there tonight, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.
وكذلك جعلناكم أمة وسلا لتكونوا شهداء على الناس ويكونوا رسول عليكم شهيدا وما جعلنا القبلة التي كنت عليها إلا لنعلم من يتبع الرسول ممن ينقلب على عقبيه وإن كانت لكبيرة إلا على الذين هدى الله وما كان الله ليضيع إيمانكم إن الله بالناس لرؤوف رحيم.
When the guys that were rid of their phones, the ones from London, the London people there was really close. The Somali Londoners, the Muslim Londoners in general, they was all like really close. And one thing I realized about it is when they all helped each other, every single one of them was exceeding, started learning Arabic, started speaking Arabic. One guy learned Arabic in 2 months. 2 months. Because he got rid of his phone. But when he was on his phone at the beginning, he was lacking. His Quran was lacking, everything was lacking. So this phone is definitely something where you have to look at. What am I spending my time on my phone? Wallahi, brothers, you have to think of it. What are you doing with your phone late nights? Allah knows what you do with your phone, big man. You get it? And these are the kind of things that kills your concentration in general, like kills your concentration. You get it? You can't concentrate properly when someone's talking to you because you're on TikTok the whole night.
But look at subhanAllah, you as a Muslim call it Somali family. So anyway, salah, you aqim salat al-dhikri. Allah says, create salah al-dhikri for my remembrance. You know that some scholars say, in hadith, that's da'if, that's me, the person who misses one salah, he might be punished for 8 years. He might be punished for 8 years.
خذ قرارا وانطلق لا تنتظر ليس كل الناس أهل للعلاء خذ قرارا وانطلق لا تنتظر ليس كل الناس أهل للعلاء ليس كل الناس أهل للعلاء كن سعيدا كن فريدا عش بفخر في الحياة لا تبالي فالمعالي بالتحدي لا سوى كن سعيدا كن فريدا عش بفخر كن بهذا العصر من أعلامه ودع الأحلام يا فارسنا كن بهذا العصر من أعلامه كن بهذا العصر من أعلامه كن سعيدا كن فريدا عش بفخر في الحياة لا تبالي فالمعالي بالتحدي لا سوى كن سعيدا كن فريدا عش بفخر في الحياة لا تبالي فالمعالي بالتحدي لا سوى بالتحدي لا سوى إنما المشتاق للمجد التليد لن تراه مستكينا كالعبيد إنما المشتاق للمجد التليد
Asan for you, man. Inna malamani, the quiet here, man. Things are determined by the last and final actions. Yeah?
Yeah?
Beautiful. It was amazing.
What do you rate out of 10?
11.
10. And what's the sleepover saying?
Amazing.
10 out of 10.
How was the sleepover, brother?
Amazing, amazing. 10 out of 10. How was the sleepover?
Me, it was good. It wasn't too bad. A lot of like running around, I like that. And I didn't get enough sleep, or like.
How was the sleepover?
Beautiful. Good to end it on.
How was the sleepover?
Don't be sleepover, great sleepover.
والعطر الرداء، خذ قرارا وانطلق.